Welcome back to TGB Reactions. I hope you're well. I hope you're having a good week. And as you probably know, if you've read my community post, I had a little bit of wax removal last week. And yeah, for a few days, my ears were like properly like tinned or picking up sort of really hissy sounds. And it's a little bit strange, to be honest. And I would recommend getting it done, but it always feels like a little bit of a trial to go through, especially as the people that do mine are really, really good, but they are trainees. So sometimes they're a little bit nervous, and that makes me nervous. And so, yeah, the whole thing's over and done with now. And safe to put my headphones back on. Although I think I was being probably a little bit overcautious, I am glad to be here now and doing some reactions because, it always feels like it's been too much of a gap. But these things happen and these things need to be done. So, I'm really, really glad to be back. And I'm going to be reacting to a track called Going Up Country. And it's by a group called Canned Heat. And this track was actually from 1969. It entered the UK Top 40 at the beginning of January. And it entered the US Hot 100 towards the end of December 1968. So it sort of straddled both years for both countries. And yes, it's really, really cool. This song was originally based on Bulldozer Blues by Henry Thomas from 1928. And the group consists of Bob Height on vocals, Alan Wilson on slide guitar, vocals, harmonica, Henry Vestin on lead guitar, Larry Taylor on bass, Adolfo Della Pana on drums. And this group was formed in Los Angeles in 1965, so around for a few years. I believe this song has sort of got connections with Woodstock. A couple of videos that came up when I put it up on the search for YouTube, they're showing bits of Woodstock. So I'm assuming that they played at Woodstock as well. So this is taken from the album. What does it say? Loving the Blues, I think that's it. That is. I sort of scribbled it down in pen, so correct me if I'm wrong. And that was from November 1968. So, without further ado, looking forward to this. It looks like somebody's put a little bit of a video to it. And I'm assuming, just from the stills, that this is probably Woodstock as well. So, yeah, I need something chilled out because I'll tell you what, boy, it's so muggy at the moment. And even though I've like washed my hair, it just everything kind of feels sticky again. So, do a few reactions, get back in the swing of it, and hopefully it won't feel too uncomfortable in its weird heat. But, I mean, I have been out, and it kind of feels fresh, but it's weird. You go into different scenarios, and you just kind of feel really muggy again. Anyway, enough moaning about the weather. It's either too hot, too cold, too wet, and that's the UK for you. So, yeah, without further ado, this is Canned Heat and Going Up Country. I'll be looking forward to this one all day.
I'm going to some place where I've never been before. I'm going where the water tastes like wine. I'm going where the water tastes like wine. We can jump in the water, stay drunk all the time.
Do you know what? I think this is probably about Woodstock, and I hope it is anyway. And if it is, let's pretend it is. It's got a different feel to Matthew's Southern Comfort, Joni Mitchell, Woodstock. That had a more of a, like a spiritual feel about finding yourself. This is about finding fun and having a good time. And it's and you can tell it's a lot more upbeat. I really enjoy the contrast, actually. Same subject, different feeling. And that's the thing, you know, with And you can describe an event to someone, but for every person that goes to that event, it may be slightly different experience. And it's really, really cool that Woodstock was this platform for all these different experiences. At least I think this is about Woodstock. That was short, but that was really, really cool. I loved his voice. I was trying to figure out how he could, whether that was his natural kind of sound or whether he was like doing something with his throat to actually kind of create that kind of vocal. But that was definitely a uniquely interesting vocal style. I bet there's people that would talk about the style of some of these singers, and you know, I mean, I could think that it's kind of like a, yeah, it's just kind of sounded like it's really sort of not straining, but just reconfiguring the way his throat behaves. I don't know. I'm sure there's a technical explanation for this. But yeah, I loved this. And I think, yeah, listening to the lyrics, it kind of sounded that it was about maybe going to Woodstock, but that Woodstock was just a beginning of a journey that's, you know, we'll start out with Woodstock. It's a bit of fun. Then we'll get right out of the city, right out of a country, maybe even out of the USA. I just love that idea. It sparks that adventuring people to you know, get up and go basically. But yeah, I loved it. I loved that little flute as well. That kind of gave it a very whimsical, humorous, and a little bit mischievous kind of feel to it. Like, you know, we're gonna have a bit of fun. We're gonna, you know, let the devil in us kind of run free. Even others are there for such a spiritual, pure experience. Maybe sort of both have the one thing in common, which is substances. But you know, you can't really sort of judge. I think when you look at certain decades that you weren't around in, that it's easy to kind of fall upon cliches of, oh yeah, the 80s were this, the 90s were that, the 60s were this. But everybody's an individual, and as I said halfway through, I think everybody's journey to Woodstock was different, their experience was different. And I remember George Harrison making comments about Woodstock at, I think he was talking about Haight-Ashbury, which is America, and he said he expected some sort of magical, mystical, spiritual experience, and he said he just was confronted by spotty kids on acid. So yeah, this is like wonderful. So a quick look at the lyrics and see if I'm on the right track. I'm going up the country, baby. Don't You Want to Go, I'm Going Up the Country, Baby, Don't You Want to Go, I'm Going to Some Place I've Never Been Before, I'm Going Where the Water Tastes Like Wine, I'm Going Where the Water Tastes Like Wine, We Can Jump in the Water, Stay Drunk All the Time, I'm Gonna Leave This City, Gotta Get Away, All of This Fussing and Fighting, Man, You Know I Sure Can't Stay. So baby, pack your leaving trunk, you know we've got to leave today. Just exactly where we're going, I cannot say, but we might even leave the USA. It's a brand new game that I want to play. No use your running or screaming and crying, because you've got a home as long as I've got mine. I really love the fact that they're saying, it's a brand new game that I want to play. It's from the little I heard about the sort of mid to late 60s with that, it was this kind of like new age of spiritual awakening. So I guess for a lot of people, it did feel like a brand new game. Obviously, the politics of governments rumble on in the background. But I think we underestimate the power of people, and that it's when people get together, they can create such, you know, really cool energy. I know this is a little bit woo-woo, but we saw this with Live Aid, and a lot of people who watch Live Aid, who have heard about Live Aid, a lot of people are cynical, saying, well, a lot of the money didn't go to where it needed to get to. It wasn't that much. But the one thing that everybody I've ever spoken to has missed about Live Aid is that it was the one moment, probably the first moment in history where it was people had access to a live event that around the globe that they could actually channel their feelings about governments, about how they spend money. And it was like a oneness. The world was like, it was genuinely at one that day during Live Aid. And I'm guessing it actually frightened the living daylights out of governments and people in power, because the last thing people in power ever want is for people to come together. And it was really, really good. And I kind of felt that, I mean, I didn't go to Live Aid, but I watched it on television, but I kind of felt that was maybe that was my Woodstock. You know, it was a spiritual moment, you know, watching some of these acts, because there was an extra dimension. They weren't just pop stars anymore. They were relaying a feeling about the day. It's very hard to explain. Anybody that wasn't alive on that day in 1985 probably wouldn't know, just as people that weren't alive in the 60s probably wouldn't appreciate the depth of you know, a festival like Woodstock, and how people kind of felt about it. And I guess that energy sort of reverberated for a long time afterwards. I mean, it still does today. People still talk about it. I'm talking about it now on YouTube in 2024. So it's such an incredible experience. And this was a lovely little track to accompany that. And I mean, I could be completely off track here. It might have nothing to do with Woodstock, but looking at these pictures, there's some kind of festival. I'm guessing. Folks, that was wonderful. I'll tell you what I'll do before I go over, before I sign off. Just have a look, see if there's any comments on this. I'm really hoping that, oh, there's only 11 comments. Every video I react to, there's only a few comments. Oh, there's a cowbell in that. I didn't even pick up the cowbell. Okay, it's not the Woodstock version, but there is flutes. Makes no sense. But yeah, do you know what? If this wasn't a Woodstock version, then that's fine. And, you know, maybe I can have a listen to that. But not having heard this track before, it's hard to know which version is which. So anyway, please join me in the comments below. And as I probably should have said at the beginning of the video, thank you to everybody that has subscribed and suggested music for this channel, and those that have donated to buy me a coffee. I really appreciate that, because over the recent months, probably 6 months, it's, you know, life has been quite bit ups and downs, you know, with personal stuff, with viruses and all sorts of stuff like that. And you know, it is just nice to react, and it is a little bit frustrating. But yeah, the Buy Me a Coffee thing really shows that sometimes I do something good on his channel, and people really appreciate it. So, I don't know why my voice is it's very hot and stuffy in this room. It's the UK. I don't have air conditioning. I have a window, but perhaps, you know, opening at that, unless there's a breeze, it might not offer any respite for this kind of weird heat that's built up in here. So, yeah, till next time, take care of yourself and have a wonderful, wonderful week.